cases for the other subjects which are considered to be part of science, not physics, that is chemistry and biology. So at present, there are many things you have already, I think, started with the other modules. So you will find that there will be a lot of overlap with quantum mechanics for these modules. And we are still at the beginning. By next lecture, we will be moving on to more little advanced stages so that you will start working on things. You will start understanding more concepts. Okay, so the question is, why exactly, or what was the need for the quantum mechanics? The point is, classical physics was challenged in two domains by new theories in the beginning of 1900. And they were the relativistic domain and the microscopic domain. So when you say relativistic domain, it was challenged by the theory of relativity proposed by Einstein. And what did Einstein say? He said that at a very, very high speed, that is the speed which is comparable to the speed of light, the Newtonian mechanics just stops. It does not work. And you cannot use the laws of motion that Newton had proposed at that level. At microscopic domain, that is at the level where you find that the atom, that is at atoms level. Yes, Ganesh.
I have some question. Can I ask?
Okay. Do you want to ask at this stage?
Yes, ma'am. From
really. Yes. Yes. Go ahead.
Ma'am, can I tell in Hindi?
Yes. Yes. No problem.
Oh. Ma'am, एक consider करिए एक torch है हमारे पास एक light beam है. वो travel कर रही है उसके साथ एक particle भी है वो भी बहुत high speed से समझ लीजिए वो particle भी speed of light से travel कर रहा है.
Okay.
और वो जब एक पार्टिकल जो है वो लाइट बीम से टकराएगा तो मैम वो जो हमारे अंदर पार्टिकल के अंदर जो कि फोटॉन्स होते हैं उनके पास रेस्ट मास तो जीरो होता है लेकिन उनका रिलेटिविस्टिक मास होता है हाई होता है
कितना होता है
इंफिनिटी मैम हम लोग कंसीडर करते हैं जनरली जब
रेस्ट मास व्हेन यू से इंफिनिटी इज दैट अ नंबर आर यू टॉकिंग अबाउट
नो मैम
सो आप जब इंफिनिटी बोल रहे हो तो सी First of all, this is a very, very hypothetical and unclear question. Unfortunately, sorry to say that. क्योंकि आप जब infinite mass कह रहे हो ना, किसी के पास infinite mass होता ही नहीं है.
नहीं मैम, as relativity बोला था जब हम लोग की मान लीजिए.
नहीं relativity में भी नहीं होता है. मैं वही कह रही हूँ. Relativity में high energy जब मैं word use करती हूँ, I have an estimate. See, when I'm saying the speed of light is comparable, when a speed of any object is comparable to speed of light, actually, आप मुझसे पूछ सकते हैं, जो कोई पूछता नहीं है student, which I think student should be asking, what do you mean by comparable? Which I think most of you have that question in mind. So by comparable, I mean there is a ratio. If I take the ratio of the speed with respect to the speed of light and that ratio turns out to be anything from 0.5 to 1, aap use comparable bolenge. Lekin if that number is less than 0.5, it is not considered as comparable. To be comparable, you have to have a specific measure. So that is why I'm saying be very careful in your question. There is nothing called as infinity because infinity is just a comparison. For I'll give a very basic example. For an ant, 1 kilometer is infinite distance. क्योंकि आप किसी computation में, किसी भी आप computational person से पूछ लेना, आप वो बोलता है मैंने infinite loop किया है. Do you really think there is something called as infinite loop? The basic logic anybody will have is your computer will die. आपका computer कितने दिन तक चलेगा? सालों तक चलता रहेगा क्या? क्योंकि infinite loop means anything. So what is infinite? Infinite I mean is something a large number that will be a well-defined number for a given situation. इसीलिए आप relativity में भी बात करें तो infinite mass मत कहिए. But anyways, please continue with the question.
मैम तो sorry मैम लेकिन वो जब मतलब वो particle जो है वो photon से मान लीजिए collide होगा.
हाँ हाँ.
तो मैम जो कि हम लोग लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ लीनियर मोमेंटम जब पढ़ते हैं तो हमारा क्या होता है कि हमारा जो पार्टिकल का अगर वेलोसिटी मूव कर रही है और दूसरा पार्टिकल भी उससे टकरा जाए तो जो आगे वाला पार्टिकल होता है उसकी वेलोसिटी बढ़ जाती है.
नॉट नेसेसरी बिकॉज़ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट कोलिजन. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ कोलिजन आर यू टॉकिंग? इज इट इलास्टिक कोलिजन और इज इट इनइलास्टिक कोलिजन? Because what I understand is you are saying there is a particle which is going to collide with the photon. Am I right to understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So there will be exchange of energy. You are absolutely correct in saying that. But whether that is an elastic process or inelastic process, nobody knows. There is a probability for both the processes. I think that's what you did in the morning. So I'll say very in a simple word, when two particles collide, okay, when I'm saying particle, I am not specifying what kind of particle I'm talking. I'm not even specifying the energy that they have. It can be in low energy range. When I say low energy, I'm talking about the range in electron volts or kilo electron volt ko bhi hum low energy bol denge. But if I say high energy, it is in GeV, TeV, okay? So I'm not talking about energy range. Irrespective of energy range, when the two particles collide, there is a probability that there can be an elastic process. This collision can be elastic or this collision can be inelastic. Based on your energy domain and based on the type of particles involved in the process, you can estimate this probability. So probability will be decided by the type of particle involved and the energy range that you are talking about. So again, when you said relativistic, always remember relativity comes into picture when you are having high energies only. Or sometimes even at high energy, it is not important. Relativistic effects are not always present. This is something very, very crucial. All of you have to remember. Because when you bring in relativity, the whole framework changes. There are many other concepts you have to take into consideration. And that is why the probability that whether the process will be elastic process or it will be the inelastic process, this will all will be converted into a number which will be called as cross-section of the process. Cross-section means how much particle has, after the process is over, you look at the probability of particle coming out from certain angle or certain area. So it will be cross-section per unit area or something like that. I mean, there are different types of cross-sections. So you are considering a three-dimensional process and then you are looking at the outcome of the process, which is probabilistic in nature, and then you assign the weight to that probability. Okay, this much is the chance that elastic collision will happen. This much is the chance that inelastic collision will happen. So always remember, when two particles collide, wherever there are two possibilities, it is either elastic in nature or inelastic in nature. We don't know precisely what is happening. Only what we can do is, out of that outcome, whatever we are interested in, we will focus on that part and we will ignore the other part. Even in the experiments which people do, the CERN experiment or anything, what do you think? People say we brought proton, one proton beam and another proton beam, and we collided. What do you think? Only one thing will happen in that collision? No, there will be lot many things happening in that collision. You talk to the experimentalists, they will say, I have collected a data. When you use the word data, it means that it is containing lot of information. Out of that, whatever I am interested in, I will pull out that information only. And probably that information is about elastic process or inelastic process. So when you are talking about this example, I will say that in that case, the other student will say, why Ganesh is saying that the other particle will speed up? probably the other particle may just absorb that whole energy and kuch aur hi ho jayega. Yes, that person is not wrong to think, because he is thinking the outcome to be that way. You are thinking outcome to be one way. But the fact is, when that process is really happening, all the things can happen. When will they happen? How will they happen? Will all depend on the energy and the particles involved. But I don't think that was the question, Ganesh. This is just an additional information I wanted you to have so that you can frame your question properly.
Yes, ma'am.